So where did you come up with Chair One Fitness? Was that, did you discover that amongst your travels?
I didn't discover it amongst my travels, but I was thrusted into it here in the United States. I was teaching my regular dance fitness classes, Zumba, all that stuff. And when I wanted to take fitness full time, I really didn't know how I would do it, because in the fitness industry, group exercise instructors don't get paid that much, at least not to make a full-time career out of it. So when I decided to take it full-time, I was fortunate enough that somebody asked me if I would be willing to teach at an adult daycare. And they said it would have to be seated. And they asked me, was I used to teaching people with wheelchairs? I said, no, but I can try. Are you used to teaching people with dementia and Alzheimer's? No, but I can try. Have you ever taught someone with a stroke? No, but I can try. And so after they told me all the different things to expect, I immediately called my grandma, picked a brain for what songs to use, and then I came up with a class, and then I started. And that's when I learned that teaching or doing something in a niche market is actually more like a specialty market. So you can command more dollars per hour. And I absolutely loved it. So I got to be around seniors, which are all like the grandmas and grandpas of the world. And I got to have another revenue stream come in, and I got to have a good time. So I just basically came about it by saying yes to somebody asking me. I'm big on saying yes.
Yeah, I love that. So the economics behind being a trainer, I guess, in a group setting, they just don't work. They, you have to do a lot of it to do it in most situations, or?
Well, the difference between your regular standing fitness class and adapting it to a chair is figuring out, okay, how do I work the muscle groups while being seated? How do I get the cardio and get the heart rate up while seated? Or how do I instruct somebody who may have a limited mobility, hence arthritis or anything like that? How do I adapt a class that somebody's going to have dementia and I need to figure out how to keep their attention if they wander off? So it just presented a bunch of new elements that you would never typically see in the gym environment. But I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed the challenge of having to learn it. And even like during the Chair One Fitness instructor training, we have a whole section called Overcoming Obstacles. And it could be stressful for some, but I just love it. I say, what are you going to do if you walk in and somebody has an oxygen tank? What are you going to do if you're talking to one of your students and their teeth fall out? What are you going to do if somebody has schizophrenia and they start tripping in the middle of class? And they're like, you've really had to experience all that? I'm like, yes.
I've been directly involved within the startup community for almost a decade. I want to talk to you about a serious pain point. Spending a ton of time trying to understand the business landscape in the 757. That's time that should be focused on growing the business. At StartWheel, we're here to help you by compiling all of the news you need to know about in one place. Now there's no need to search multiple websites. Just head to startwheel.org and see for yourself. That's startwheel.org.